They have intentionally designed a product that is addictive. They understand that if children stay online, they make more money. It doesn't matter how harmful the material is.
So the fact that these kids ended up seeing the things that they saw that were so disturbing wasn't by accident. It was by design.
Absolutely. This is not a coincidence.
Isn't it the parents' job to monitor this stuff?
Well, of course it is. I'm all for parental responsibility, but these products are explicitly designed to evade parental authority.
I knew her password.
And began digging through his daughter's phone for answers. He found an Instagram post sent to England from a friend.
There was a video, and that video was a lady on Instagram pretending to hang herself. And that's ultimately what our child did. Because you ask yourself, how did she come up with this idea? And then when I did the research, there it was. She saw it on Instagram. It was on her phone.
If that video wasn't sent to her, because she copied it, she wouldn't have had a way of knowing how to do that certain way of hanging yourself.
Nearly a year and a half after England's death, that hanging video was still circulating on Instagram with at least 1,500 views. Tony Roberts says it was taken down in December 2021. The Roberts are suing Meta, the parent company to Instagram.
If they so-called monitor and do things, how could it stay on that site? Because they're part of their policy states they don't allow for self-harm photos, videos, things of that nature. So who's holding them accountable?
So what needs to be done?
Number one is age and identity verification. You know, that technology exists. You know, if people are trying to hook up on Tinder, there's technology to make sure that the people are who they say they are. Number two would be turn off the algorithms. You know, there's no reason why Alexis Spence, who was interested in exercise, should have been directed toward anorexic content. Number three would be warnings. So that parents know what's going on. Let's be realistic. You're never going to have social media platforms be 100% safe. But, you know, these changes would make them safer.